Hi everyone, let's get started today by creating a beautiful agent in Voiceflow using their agent stack and specifically a voice agent for the loan industry. Okay, so let's get started by showing you the demo quickly and then we'll go into the build part of this. So let me start.
Hello, welcome to Acme Mortgage. How can I help you?
Hi, I'm looking to technically have a loan for my house. How can you help me?
I can hear you might be a bit nervous. That's totally normal when it comes to mortgages. Take a breath and let's start simple. Could you share what you'd like help with today? Are you looking to buy your first home, refinance, or just exploring your options?
I'm technically trying to buy my first home.
That's exciting. Congratulations on taking this big step. I'd love to help you through this process. Before we dive in, could I get your name so I can assist you better?
My name is...
Nice to meet you, Akshat. And could I also get your email address? This helps me keep track of our conversation and send you any helpful information.
You can just write AB...
Perfect, I've got your details saved. Now, since you're looking to buy your first home, let's start by understanding what you might qualify for. What's your approximate annual household income before taxes?
Around $100,000.
Great, $100,000 is a solid income. Now, which range best describes your credit score? 600 to 649, 650 to 699, 700 to 749, 750 blah blah. This helps me estimate what interest rates you might qualify for.
My credit score is around 700 to 750.
Perfect. A credit score in the 700 to 750 range is excellent and will help you get competitive rates. Now, what's your target price range for the home you're looking to buy? This helps me calculate the loan amount you'll need.
Perfect. Now, again, we can go through the whole agent. It takes a couple of minutes to have the whole conversation and explain which products you can talk about. I have a detailed agent running here, right? And the best part is it sounds very natural. There is nothing crazy. And I'm speaking in like, you know, Indian English accent. So that was also easily recognizable. Now, that's not for me, but also for the technology that's running. But let me quickly show you, like, you know, again, all the steps that we took. You might have heard a bit of delay for it to respond. That was not mostly about the agent, but because I have around 4 mics here running and I'm only controlling one of them. Probably it was still hearing some noise in the background and that's why taking a bit more time to listen and then respond. You will not have that issue when you're talking in production because someone's going to just talk on a phone or something like that. But yeah, on recording that does sound like it takes so much time, it does not. Okay, so now let's talk about the build part. So let me walk you through the agent here, what I created and also how I created this particular prompt. And I'll tell you exactly how you can repeat this. First of all, I always use a persona prompt style because I really like it and it's easier to just treat the agent as a person. Very simply, we give it a name. It's Margo, right? Again, obviously, I've used Markdown. Tell it a personality. Tell it what the personality feels like. Keep it reassuring. Depends on if you're selling e-commerce or creating a support agent. You're technically trying to make sure that warm, welcoming, and all of those things. Speech characteristics are very simply add a conversational rhythm. This is super important because agents mostly sound like a perfect English, and that's not how people speak. People speak in very different formats. Like, again, even the conversation, if you heard what I was speaking, has a slight accent that I have, that's Indian accent of speaking English. I would technically speak in a much faster way. So I technically want to hear something which is sounds real human, and that's how you can do that. Again, conversation flow, always keep responses and answers to under 50 words or 2 sentences to make sure that, you know, it's not massive, because if you have like a massive response that AI is generating and then you're just transcribing it, nobody's going to listen to that, and very easily people are going to figure out, like, you know, they're talking to a robot and they're not going to be happy with that. Collect the user's input right after the welcome part and then the last utterance, right? Again, I tell it, like, you know, to work accordingly. If the user sounds anxious or frustrated, this is a bit hit and a miss because it can't really predict the emotions from the conversation itself or the input that I've given. Even if it is like there, it's just telling you nicely, like, here is how we can do that. You might sound a bit nervous. Let's try to do this together. Kind of like, you know, depends on the agent that you're creating. You can completely remove that if you're doing this for agents which don't require that much reassurance. For example, if someone needs tech support, completely fine, like, you know, again, but depends, like, you know, completely your call. Open-ended question, choose that, again, what you want, how they want to help. Simplify what the user requests based on what the user wants. I'll just, like, you know, zoom out a bit so you can see this more clearly. Based on the user's input, do you want to do one of these things, right? Send them to either pre-qualification, send them either to product matching. Let's say they already know, like, you know, okay, I'm already looking for a home. But one thing I added is most use. If you pretend for the user that already has knowledge and is looking for a loan, we technically can't capture their details in product match. That's not what I want to do. I technically want to capture their details in this particular agent here. So I've asked it always start with pre-qualification and then move on to the next part. So pre-qualification, pretty simple, ask basic questions and everything else. And then based on that, it goes ahead and chooses what needs to be done. If no intent matches, credit match, again, like, you know, very simply have a quick question or tell them that a human is going to call you back and everything else. That's why we record, like, you know, if you remember the conversation. It asks me for my name and email first thing so that I can come back and refer here. Again, very simple. Other response guidelines, keep it short. Ask critical data. Ask one question at a time, super important. Don't make it ask 100 questions at the same time. Strictly a single question at every time and then just go for it from there. Scenario handling, based on like above, it will send it to the particular agent. A couple of things here. Knowledge base, we have added a narrative base to capture records. Let's say you have a knowledge base where you technically want, like, you know, if you want to create a support agent, you will technically use this. So it should be able to go and fetch data records and come back here. Set up some guardrails. Please do set them up. Don't leave this blank and then go it from there. And then you have the call management and everything. Yes, this is a massive prompt because it's a massive agent, right? If you scroll through this, it's not that massive. Like, again, like, I think, like, you know, again, around 100 lines, something like, again, on like page, or like, again, right, around 300 to 400 words. And that's fine. That's the kind of agents you need so that it can handle all the cases that a human technically will be able to handle. And this will still be like, you can create enough, right? When you're trying to do, you should also try to do a bit more if you're required. Now, when you ask for an email and phone number, I actually also have a tool where technically create user record. Now, obviously, which is simple, right? Again, I just have an API tool. You can see here, this is the ATIP, right? Again, which has the name and email and everything else. I post data and send it to a record. If you don't know how to connect API to Voiceflow, there is a video somewhere here. Go ahead and check that out. It's super easy. Just input all the details as it is. Now, the only thing that you need to create in addition to this is mention name and email, and then you just have to come here and press curly braces and type in name. Let me just zoom in so you guys can see this, right? And once I type in name and press this, it gives me an option to select the variable. Ensure to do that. This should look blue. I don't know how much you can see the color. It should not look green. If it looks green, it's not right. It should look blue. This is super simple. Airtable has great documentation how to do that, but very simply, you're just creating a post request that links to Voiceflow and that gets converted to a tool. Okay, and then again, input variable settings. Here we are setting up, should the agent collect this? 110% yes, and should the email collect this? Yes. If we switch this off, then you'd need to give a default value or something like that. That would help, but if you are okay to collect this, go ahead with that. Now again, capturing response, this is super easy. Save to variable, and then it connects there and captures the record ID. Why am I capturing this? I'll tell you in a second. Then we have a knowledge base. I used a company's knowledge base called raid.com. This is a pretty cool company. They don't have an agent. I'm pretty sure if I'm calling them, it's just someone picking up or something like that. But yeah, like, you know, again, like, you know, this company is pretty popular in US. That's what I at least searched around, and like, you know, we can probably look for something like this and create something for them. We choose a model. I'm preferably choosing Cloud for Sonnet. I've set up the number of tokens. Also, technically not exceed that a lot because you want the responses to be short. But also, in case your responses are a bit more technical, try to increase this max tokens much higher. Okay, perfect. This is done. Now, what happens after this is very simply is the best way to create these kind of prompts. I will not suggest you to try to write them yourself. You will spend a lot of time, and that's great if you want to practice a couple of them. But after that, I just created a master prompt, right? Again, which is able to do all of this stuff. And again, used meta prompting to prompt using ChatGPT. If you want this prompt, it will be available in the description below. So go ahead and check that out. It can technically create any prompt that I want. I'll actually show you how we are going to use this prompt to create the general queries agent. Similarly, I have the pre-qualification agent here. Again, I have update user data option here. And then again, you have all the same similar kind of information. Added a couple of things there and XYZ. Similar format, name is same and everything else. The knowledge base has an access to it. The only one thing I've done on the pre-qualification agent is that if it ends the conversation, right, then it just simply goes there. But in case the user after pre-qualification wants to move to, like, you know, I want to know more about your product, or I want to suggest, select a product, they can do that. So that's interesting. And if I show you, like, you know, this is very simply, you'll see the difference and, like, you know, kind of like, you know, how it welcomes you. It's in case someone directly comes to the product match agent, the agent should still try to, like, you know, ask more questions and get collect more details because we need that information available. Very simply, this is how our table looks like. So again, you've seen akshat@gmail.com got captured automatically here. There are some other things that I've tested till yesterday and some real-time data. Why am I showing you this? In this particular agent, we have an update option. So technically, it uses this tool to update the user data. And that's where I used the user records ID. And that's why I don't want to make it a default value. And here we can input ID that it should use. So what happens here, very simply, is that whatever user gets created here, the same user gets updated on the pre-qualification agent. Let's see, there is probably an error somewhere around here. Value provided. I don't want it to collect this. So to check that out, come here and click on edit and see where the issue is. Within credit score, property price, qualification status. Everything's good. Even records ID is there. We can test here by inputting all of these details. Let's do that. Technically, we can also get rid of that particular part because the data is already existing. Income, 400, credit score, I'm typing. And then we have the record ID here. So if I click on this, I should get the record ID. And I copy the record ID and then paste it here. So let's test this out. I think this should run. Could not pass request body. So again, that's a good learning point for us to update this. Let's test it in a second. Property price obviously can't be a string. It needs to be a number. I was putting a string because when I was testing it. So again, I just changed it and it updates, right? And because it updates, you can see in the table, technically if I refresh this, it should work. It has all the details that come there. So what happens now is that your agent is actually working like an agent. A lot of people start with building agents. They'll be like, this does not work, that does not work, it does not connect. We're just building it wrong. Everything is possible. You just need to figure out how to do it. Okay, and these kind of things will happen. So be fine. Like, you know, again, I get a ton of errors and I still figure them out. This is working. I have still no idea why this is throwing up an error. And that's probably, like, you know, missing input variable description. I don't know, like, again. So I don't know. If you want to capture this, you can capture the information and everything else. Just leave it there. So again, probably an error that is there, but it's fine. It obviously goes ahead and creates all of these cool stuff. Now, let's quickly try to actually create a general queries agent, which technically refers to the knowledge base and comes back. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm just simply going to open ChatGPT. You can see here very simply we have created it. Just to give it a quick input, that create a like agent for this, and then you have all of this running in the same format. This is the master prompt template. So you have the whole persona, XYZ, and then again all of the informations. What I'm going to do is again very simply copy this. That's the easiest part. I'm going to copy this and paste it in a general queries agent. We're going to link this, create an agent. I hope I haven't created one before. Perfect. New agent. I can paste this, right? I wanted to copy this in the Markdown format. Let me copy it using that. You can click on that copy, and because I like to see Markdown here itself, and again, it's in the same format. Obviously, names and all will be a problem because it has to be like, you know, Margo, and then again, very simply has access to it, right? The only thing I need to describe here is that you are going to always refer to the knowledge base for any more details. To the knowledge base for getting more information about the company and details. Okay, so this is super cool. We'll just name it as general queries agent. And once that's done, it technically has access to knowledge base and should work completely fine. So let's say we come here, we just test it. It will take a couple of seconds to load up for the agent because agents are like, again, these massive prompts, send out the tool call and brings it. I love that Voiceflow. If you want to see an old workflow, I'll show that to you. This is the response that came. I don't like this response at all because this is fine with chat agent. It's not going to work for everything. So one thing that, again, I think, like, you know, the conversation flow, again, I think we need to add that sentence, right? Sure. So I'm just writing it here and paste conversation flow. Ensure the response is always less than one sentence or 30 words. And in addition to that, also check the previous conversation. So in case we are coming to this agent after a conversation, then it's fine, right? Again, so let's try it. Let's play this again. This technically is not supposed to be the start point of the agent, so also might be like, you know, behaving this when I'm testing a couple of things out. It does make sense, but very simply, like, you know, what we would technically want to do is just, okay, how can I help you with your home loans questions to it? This is fine because there is no previous conversation, right? And we're just going to write, name this path home if the user wants to explore products or do something other than questions getting answered. Other than general queries, send them back to home. Right, again, so this is perfect, right? What I do here is like technically, and like, you know, connect this back to the home agent, right? So orchestrated agent, because now, and I'll just zoom out so you guys can see, this is now much better because I have an agent that technically has multiple agent access to. All the agents are linked back to each other. So they can talk to each other, the other agents which are technically here. And then as you see, we have connected other agents to be part of each other. I can also connect the general queries agent to the other agents in case I want to. But that would not be a good design because we already have an orchestrator agent that should be able to redirect people to the other agents. So again, super interesting workflow. And also given that I have had multiple conversations with it and I felt like it really came out very well. And I was like, this really works out for mortgage industries or anything else. And if you want to do customizations, add more functions, API call, feel free to do that. And you can do that in the agents, as I told you. If you want help, just let me know and I'll be able to help you. I hope you enjoyed the video. This was a pretty interesting use case for me to build. I'm building from outside in, like to look from a user's perspective on what an agent will look like. Obviously, there will be nuances that you want to edit and update on that. Let me know in the comment section what you would expect the agent to do more or less of. This is a super cool way to get started. One last thing I need to mention before we close this. You can add multiple tools. You can even add an MCP server. You can add different functions and set up an MCP server and connect this to Voiceflow, and that can also operate out of here. So again, ton of things possible. It's literally whatever you imagine is possible here. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please like, share, and subscribe. If you need help with AI, go down to the link below and sign up for a quick call right now so I can see you in the next one. Bye-bye.